these docks right here for the OK Corral, which is a little restaurant exclusively for these blue boats. You got to take a boat ride to come down here to it. I don't know if you actually got to go around the corner there and see it, but they offer a few different trips out here a year, or during the week they have lunch and dinner, then on the weekends they do a brunch and dinner trip. You'll see the restaurant up there high and to the left. They rebuilt it a little over 12 years ago, put over $2 million into that little facility. Open air deck seating, log cabin style feel. We can accommodate up to 400 guests at one time, Rancher. Isn't that amazing? The little kitchen puts out a lot of food. All right, that mountain to the right, there's a guardrail up there, there's a roadway, you can see the guardrail way up there. That actually wiped the old roadway out that was up there, and there was over 2 feet of water over that road. Isn't that amazing? All that flood water comes down, hits this narrow little canyon. It has nowhere to go, so it just piles up and gets deeper and deeper and deeper. In fact, the canyon is the most dangerous place to be during high water. Very turbulent, big boils, very easy to get in trouble, especially if you're not wearing a life jacket out here in a raft or in a drift boat. Now, a couple movies filmed down here in Hellgate Canyon. Rooster Cogburn with John Wayne. All the Gatling gun scenes are filmed down here. The most recent movie is a movie called River Wild with Kevin Bacon and Meryl Streep. Now, in fact, the boat you are sitting in right now helped quite a bit in the making of that movie. They shuttled the cast, the crew, and equipment up and down this river during the entire filming of that. Now, half of it was filmed here on the road, the other half on the Kissimmee River up in Montana. And then there was a two-part episode of an old TV show called Gunsmoke filmed down here. And in that episode of Gunsmoke, there was a jump that took place downstream off the front of the boat, up high and on the right. There's a rock that pokes out a little further than the rest. That is where that jump happened. And before they allowed the stuntman to make that jump, it's going to be up here a little bit, they sent a diver down in the water to make sure there was no rocks or structures that he would hit when he would make that jump. If he were to jump today, he would land just out in front of the boat. That big rock sticking out there just about above us on the right, yeah. So that the diver's down there swimming around looking for rocks, and he comes flying up out of the water, jumps back in the boat, is absolutely terrified because he's seen a monster down here in Hellgate Canyon. Well, apparently when he was looking for rocks, he come face to face with a sturgeon. I don't know if you've ever seen a sturgeon or not, but they're a very large, prehistoric-looking type fish. In fact, a freshwater sturgeon can get up to 12 foot long in length. Very, very big.
Yep.
One of our other boat pilots, his parents have both caught them out here on the Rogue River. One was 7'2" and one was 7'6". So, another question asked all the time is how deep is the water down here in the canyon? And back in the 60s, they did a survey, and they found that it was right around average depth. Just seeing if you all paid attention back here. A little over 100 feet deep at the deepest point they can find. Now, we have brought our powerboats down here. The deepest we can find is about 40 foot deep, so it has filled in quite a bit over the years. All right, well, this is the beginning of the whitewater section. So this first rapid that we are going to go down through is called Dunripple. It's a class 2, 2.5 rapid. We're going to go down the center of the river, cut left to the left bank, go bouncing down that left side bank. Sometimes a little water comes in the boat. I'll try to be as nice as I can to you, but it happens. So he signed up for the whitewater trip, right? And we actually have a spotter that's going to stay ahead of us and follow us. He's up on the highway. He keeps an eye on all these little areas like Dunripple, Argo, places that there's not enough room for these big boats and the raft. So let's get on the radio here and see how it's looking. All right, now how are we looking?